Will I find peace and calm within? You feel on such an intense level, the depth of your feeling is non-normative. The depth of your feeling is non-normative, not wrong. That doesn't make it wrong. We have sensitive people in this group, in this community, and watching this right now. We're sensitive people. Bible calls us a peculiar people. It's because we feel, we sense, we desire, we long for a greater connection. You have all of these things plus 100% more when it comes to feeling. This is not a handicap or a disadvantage. This is a matter of legislating, moderating, and mitigating when appropriate, not indulging lower vibrational ideas, narratives, and moods when they are upon you. And they are upon you as often as they are because you are so connected to the energy. So earth grounds you very strongly. Earthing is something that you should do. Connecting, allowing your energy to blend with Gaia energy. So I think you're in Body of Light. I think you listen. I know you were at the retreat, so you understand about gridding yourself to the earth, to Gaia energy, and also allowing that to open you up from crown and beyond. So your crown part and your body part is just a light, but you get them mixed up, Tiff. Some of the stuff coming down from, and I'm talking, slow it down, please. Some of the things that are coming in from 7 through 12, these are your chakras, these are also the dimensions. Some of the things that are coming down, you feel in your body and you mistake it for something that's within the body, within the emotionality, within the anxiety, within the fear, within the worry. You have not learned yet to sift through the various stimuli coming in, and there's a lot of stimuli here. Your ability to feel deeply is connected to your ability, non-normative, to love very deeply. Non-normative, meaning most people can't access love the energy quite the way that you can. It doesn't mean we can't or don't or align or go through the process of aligning. We do, but you non-normative access to great love, which has a shadow to it. If we don't legislate, moderate, mitigate correctly, if we don't know how to work with this, with great power comes great responsibility. Who said that? Well, RuPaul. With great power comes great responsibility. So if you're not being very disciplined and very vigilant about your moods, about your thoughts, then all these things get mixed up, muddled up, and you are in chaos. For you, we need proactive life design, meaning your friends are the ones that support and enrich you. All relationships support and enrich you. And if they do not, and if they don't serve you for right now, turn the dial down. Your space has to be arranged in such a way to support what it is you're calling into your life. The people you're around, even the work that you do, you're so sensitive. That's not a bad thing. It's because of your capacity to feel love, and that's what the world needs. But you're in chaos around it because of your ability to feel. And I'm just telling you something that you already know. Maybe it has or has not been articulated to you. So what is the answer, Spirit? What is the answer? It is through diligence, routine, and discipline, and practices. It's through waking up at the same time every single day. It's through making sure you have rituals, edifying rituals, also food, substances, like getting monkishly disciplined about this. Monkishly, meaning austere, meaning super strict with yourself. And Neville teaches us, we don't have the luxury to indulge our bad moods. Man, we're always creating. And the moment we become aware that we are in a negative space, we're thinking negative thoughts, we are in a state of worry, we don't have the luxury to stay in that. We all experience that. That's called being human. And that's okay. No judgment for being human. But where we have to be careful is how long do we indulge that and let that get away from us? Because that's what we're creating. So because of your capacity to feel and also to feel in the shadow of the love, you create from there too. You create from there too. Do you see how powerful you are? Magnificent. Do you get a sense of how powerful you are? It's all about control. It's all about being super hyper aware and controlling what you allow yourself to feel and to think, what you allow to be around you, and what you point your interest at. Then we get to spend more time in the very pure stream of love. God is love. God is love. Perfect love casts out all fear. So all the things you're afraid of, those things don't really exist when you get back into the space of your heart, the power of your heart. Non-normative, my friend, for you to get there, and powerful for you to vibrate from there. Magnificent, but you're chaos right now, hun. And so, God, we would ask that you would make a way where there seems to be no way. You would create the path and light it up, God, so that Tiff knows where to go, when to go there, how to think, how to feel, when it's going off the path, when she needs to return to it. We pray for calmness and serenity and clarity of thought, the ability to focus the heart and the intention of the heart and the energy of the heart in the areas of life she wishes to grow, because what a magnificent power she has in this regard. And in the most comfortable way possible, God, we ask that you would light up the obstacles. Let's use a different color light, a different kind of energy, but let Tiff know when there's an obstacle around her, something that's causing her to click out of alignment with the love, so that she may become aware of it, love herself despite it, and then consciously release it, perpetually, consciously releasing, releasing, releasing. Let Tiff know what these are so she can do that work, because sometimes it's just too loud. I can't hear, I can't see, I don't know what's going on, right? So we pray for the clear path, the clear voice, and also for some discipline. You got what it takes for that. You could do that. In God's name we pray together, Tiff, you and I, and all of us agree, amen.